Bom pessoal, aqui é o Gus69 do Metal Open Mind. Só uma mensagenzinha, o vídeo dessa semana é em inglês, porque eu estou comemorando os meus primeiros 100 inscritos no novo canal que eu criei, só para comunidade de colecionadores no YouTube, mais conhecida como VC, Vinyl Community, também como MC, Music Community. Alguns de vocês já devem ter visto alguns desses vídeos que eu tenho feito para lá. E tô fazendo esse concurso, olha, meu gato acabou de saltar. Eu vou fazer uma viagem em setembro, então durante agosto todo vai estar valendo esse concurso. Quem quiser participar, é em inglês, tem que ser inscrito aqui, ou aqui no canal do Metal Open Mind, ou lá no canal meu pessoal, Gus69. Eu vou deixar aqui o link para vocês verem. Esse vídeo também vai estar lá postado. E quando você fizer uma resposta, os três challenges que eu faço no vídeo, você vai ter que gravar um vídeo, obviamente, né? Em inglês, é obrigatório ser em inglês. Vai ter que fazer o mesmo esforço que eu estou fazendo para fazer esses conteúdos em inglês. Se você é aqui do Brasil, obviamente, né? Já tem pessoal já respondendo fazendo um vídeo resposta para esse concurso, então não perca tempo. Vai poder enviar esse vídeo, me avisar, né? Avisa aqui nos comentários: olha, já fiz o vídeo, eu vou lá e eu vou criar uma playlist, eu vou estar colocando todos os participantes do concurso. E daí no dia 7 de setembro eu vou publicar o resultado, vou fazer um sorteio e vou publicar o resultado de um vencedor. Esse vencedor vai ganhar um disco. Pode ser vinil, pode ser um CDs, no valor de 25 a 30 dólares, o que seria mais ou menos por volta de 100 reais. Só que eu vou comprar esse material lá em São Francisco. Então eu vou visitar uma loja, que é a Amoeba, que tem lá em São Francisco, Amoeba Records, e eu vou filmar, né? Pronto, quando eu souber quem é o vencedor, eu vou conversar com ele, saber o gosto dele, saber o que ele gostaria de ganhar. E quando eu estiver lá na loja, eu vou filmar e ele vai poder escolher um disco até esse valor. E eu vou enviar, se for qualquer parte do mundo, eu vou enviar, né? Se for aqui do Brasil, eu trago para cá e envio quando eu voltar. Se for nos Estados Unidos, eu envio de lá. Se for na Europa, eu vou ver, talvez envie de lá, porque seja mais em conta. Mas é só para dar o toque. Agora vocês vão ver o vídeo completo, onde eu mostro exemplos das respostas aos challenges que eu fiz. São três. O primeiro eu dou 5 possibilidades, mas para quem é aqui do Brasil vai ser fácil, porque é sobre o Brasil, sobre músicos brasileiros. Então os outros dois vocês já vão saber. Eu não vou falar mais nada, vai ter que entender em inglês para poder responder em inglês, tá? Então é isso aí, esse é o Gus. Fiquem com o vídeo da semana, o concurso de 100 inscritos do canal do Gus69, Gustavo Scafura, aqui do Metal Open Mind. Valeu!
Hello VC, hello Metal Open Mind friends, hello music community in general. Here's Gus69 holding for the first time a contest for my first 100 subscribers on my English channel, where I'm trying to practice my English. I'm sorry about that when I misspell things or names or bands' names. I'm sorry about that, but I'm trying to improve my English. So everybody who follows me on my main channel, Metal Open Mind, or my secondary channel, Gus69, will be allowed to participate on this contest. But you're gonna have to do a video in English, okay? So, there are three things that I want you to show me on your video. The first thing, and I'm gonna be showing examples of what I'm asking, okay? So, are three things I'm gonna ask for you. One is about my country, Brazil. One is about my project, Metal Open Minds. And the third thing is about my mind, in this case, your mind. I'll be visiting San Francisco for the first time in September, from the 8th to the 28th. So 20 days, I'll be there, 3 weeks in San Francisco. And the prize for this contest, I will be buying for you, the winner. There will gonna be a drawing for the winner among all the people who's gonna participate on this. And I will be announcing 1 day before my trip to San Francisco, in the September 7th, and the winner will choose a record from Amoeba in San Francisco. So I'll be there, I'll be filming, and the winner will be picking something that he likes, he or she likes, among the things I'll be browsing there, okay? It can be used, it can be brand new, it can be CD, LP, but a record, a music record, okay? And I think my budget can afford around $25-$30, but I will send worldwide. If you, the winner comes from Europe or anywhere in the world, I will be sending, okay? So let's get started with this. I want three things on your video in English, okay? The first thing I want you to show is two items of your collection from the list below. I will put the list in the description, but I'm gonna say five things, and you're gonna pick two of them, any combination of two, to show me, okay, for this first question. So five things I'm gonna, it's like different things, so you can find any of these, okay? An album from a Brazilian band or artist. So I'm gonna be showing here Raul Seixas. It's a rock and roll singer from the 70s. He died in the late 80s. So this is a very well-known artist here in Brazil from the 70s and the 80s, Raul Seixas. This is actually his fourth studio album. Artists or a band such as Mamonas Assassinas. It's like Assassin Tits, something like that. And this was a very famous band for two reasons. This was their first and only album with this name, Mamonas Assassinas, and it was released in 94, I think, in the mid 90s. And it sold like 3 million records here in Brazil. And the year after the release, the band, all band members died in a plane crash. So it was very huge here in Brazil. I was living in Portugal when this happened, but everybody knows about this band because of their unfortunately ending. So this is one. Show me an artist or band from Brazil, any. Another alternative, a song or album recorded live in Brazil. So this can be any international artists, such as Iron Maiden. They record this album live at Rock in Rio, for instance. Another example, Rush. They also, you can show, for this one, you can show also DVDs, it's okay. This one was recorded live in Rio de Janeiro. Rush from Canada. So this is the second option, a song or album recorded live in Brazil. Third option, an album from an international band with a Brazilian musician. So, international bands such as Agent Steel, speed metal from the 80s. Their singer is his name is John Cyrus. He was born here in Santos. It's a city here in the São Paulo state, but he moved to United States very young, I believe, and it's not well known, but he's born in Brazil, and he's back with this band. So this is a band that's still active nowadays, and they are recording a new album. So Agent Steel, John Cyrus. Another example, a newer one, Kiko Loureiro is now playing with Megadeth. So he recorded the last album by Megadeth. So this is the third option. An album from an international band with a Brazilian musician or singer. Now, fourth option, an album with a guest musician from Brazil. So it's not a member, an actual member, but it's a guest appearance in an album. So I'm gonna show two examples. This one, this is actually Frank Sinatra album with Antonio Carlos Jobim, Bossa Nova King from Brazil, Antonio Carlos Jobim, or he is also known as Tom Jobim. This is not rock and roll, of course. You can show other styles of music if you want. It's not required to be all rock bands or heavy metal bands. You can show anything. So this is one example. And another one from Portugal, Moonspell. They had a best player from Brazil, Sergio Cristana, from 97 to 2003. I think he recorded three or four albums. This one is the Butterfly Effect. He recorded this one with Moonspell. Okay. Final option. To pick two from. An album with a song about Brazil, or title, or lyrics about Brazil. Okay? So I'm gonna be showing two examples for this one. Soulfly. This is actually American band formed by a Brazilian musician, Max Cavalera from Sepultura. But this is not a Brazilian band, it's an international American band. And this is there is a song here called Brazil. So you can show a title song with Brazil in the name, with S or Z, doesn't matter. Or an album, a song, or even mentioning in the lyrics, it's okay. I'm gonna show this one, Aldi Meola, Elegant Gypsy. There is a song here called Sister of Brazil. Okay? So if you don't find Brazil in the title of the song or the album, you can show a lyric mentioning Brazil. Okay? So these are my examples for the first challenge, where you can pick two of these five options to show. Okay? I will be putting everything on the description so you can understand what I'm asking for this contest. Next, second challenge, show an album with a song title mentioning the word mom. As you can already know, Metal Open Mind, I sometimes use mom as a short for Metal Open Mind. But for this one, you can use the word mom in different contexts, as like a mother, mommy, or mom, just mom. Doesn't have to mean Metal Open Mind. This is only meaning for me. But I want you to show an album with a song title mentioning this word, mom. If you don't find mom, it's okay to show mommy or mother, okay? I'm gonna show some examples, like a band with mother, Mother Love Bone. Their first and only a studio album, because the singer died before the release, from Seattle, right on the beginning of the grunge era in the 90s. Mother Love Bone, or a title of the album. This is a solo album by Rich Kotzen. It's called Mothers, Heads, Family Reunion. So there is mother on the title. And my last example, you can show records or CDs, doesn't matter. This is a Scatterbrand album, Here Comes Trouble. And there is a song here, what it is? Side two, Hello Mom. So this is on, it's perfect, because it's a mom like Metal Open Mind. Okay, for the, this is for the second challenge, mom. You wanna show one album with mom, mother, mommy, whatever you find in your collection. And the third and last challenge, show an album from your collection that made you open your mind to other styles of music that you were not familiar until that point. So I started listening, like consuming music with hard rock and heavy metal. I didn't listen anything other than hard rock and heavy metal until I found about some guitar player doing instrumental albums such as Tony McAlpine, Edge of Sanity, like instrumental albums. And I bought a lot of this kind of stuff, most of them from this label, Shrapnel Records. So I had Vinnie Moore, Greg Howe, Jason Becker, Mark Friedman, what else? There is more. All guitar-oriented, guitar, instrumental music. And when I started listening to this kind of stuff, it clicked my mind to listen other styles they are influenced by, such as jazz or classical music or traditional music from other countries. And because they, for this kind of instrumental style of music, they can pick stuff from different genres, blues or anything actually. And one of the greatest for me is Steve Vai. This is a Passion and Warfare studio album. Again, this one only instrumental, not just a little more mainstream than the other ones I just mentioned. Steve Vai, who came from a background with Frank Zappa, so Frank Zappa music could do anything, and he continued doing that, but with a little bit a punch of hard rock. Played with Whitesnake after that, so, but his solo career is pretty amazing for me. Another great guitarist for me is Satriani. So this kind of guys with this type of instrumental music made my mind open to progressive music, progressive rock, progressive metal, jazz, fusion, anything that is good, these guys opened my mind to. So I want you to show me something. If you are if you consider yourself an open-minded person, I want you to show me what album that you heard that clicked you to listen different styles of music that you are not familiar until that point. Okay, so this is my contest. I'm inviting everybody that follows me on my Metal Open Minds channel. I have 1,200, I think, right now, subscribers on my channel, Metal Open Mind. I will be posting this video on the two channels, on my Gus69 in the English channel and my main channel in Portuguese. So I want to invite these viewers to follow me on my English channel. I'll be leaving a link in the description, so you can follow me there too. But this video will be in both channels, so just to let you know that I'm inviting everyone to participate in this contest, and I hope you, if you are the lucky winner, I'm hoping to get something very special for you from Amoeba. I can't wait. I've never been on that coast, on the San Francisco, California, never been there. So it will be my first time, and I'm hoping to feel to shot some videos there, and also to buy something for you. So participate, subscribe, make a video. Let me know that you made a video in the description, in the comment section. I will be creating a playlist with all the entries, so you can see what others are doing for this contest. So I think it's all. Deadline is the end, the last day of August, the 31st of August, and I'll be doing a drawing in the before I go to San Francisco in September 7. Okay, I think that's all. Thank you for your support, thank you for watching, and God bless you. Stay metal, open minds.